Hey everyone, if you're curious about local LLMs and how to work with them, this video is for you. There are multiple reasons why one might prefer using local LLMs over API-based LLMs such as ChatGPT, Gemini, or Claude. And to name some of those reasons, for example, you might have privacy concerns, maybe you have sensitive data, even for your own personal usage, or maybe you're working in a company that its privacy policy doesn't allow you to use ChatGPT, for example, then the solution is to use local LLMs. Or as another reason, sometimes, you know, you have cost concerns. You don't want to spend a lot of money on API calls or pay for subscriptions. In those cases, again, local LLMs are the answers. And other than that, maybe you have a use case that you don't want your project or your application to be always online. You want it to also work offline. So again, local LLM is the go-to solution. So today I'm going to talk briefly about Ollama. It's a tool for setting up and working with large language models locally on your own machine. It doesn't even need GPU. You're good to go with your CPU as well. Of course, maybe you cannot run a very large model on your CPU, but trust me, there are lots of small-sized models, you know, in the order of 4 GB or something like that, that can do your task quite effectively. I'll talk about how to chat with a model in Terminal using Ollama and how to call that model using their API locally, for example, from Terminal or from Python. And then I'll briefly introduce Msty. It's a UI developed for chat environments, quite the same as ChatGPT. So you can even have an environment like ChatGPT, but totally locally on your own machine. So let's take a quick look at Ollama website. Well, their website is so simple. There's a GitHub part. It's very good for developers. We'll visit it momentarily. And there is a models page. Let's go there. You can see there are a lot of models. You see a lot of models, a lot of large language models or even vision models with different capabilities. Some of them for pure text tasks, some of them for vision tasks, some of them for calling tools or for reasoning, for embedding. If you have, for example, a RAG application, you can use the embedding ones. And you can see the most popular ones here. You can start getting an idea what a vast collection of models are sitting here. So to install Ollama, it's so simple. You can just click on this download button and follow the steps. I'm sure you can do it on your own. It's super simple. So once you have Ollama installed, you can run it easily. And if you can see its icon, it means that it's up and running. So for example, here's the icon for me. And let me show you a very brief example. So I can say, for example, Ollama run. And for a very simple example, let me use Llama 3.2. Now it's ready to chat. I can say, hi, how are you? I'm just a language model, so I don't have feelings or emotions like humans. Okay, so you see how simple it is, and also it has context. You know, it remembers what you asked and what was the prior state of your conversation. So for example, I can say, what did I just ask? You ask how I am. Okay, so it remembers. But you also have some choices. If you put slash and question mark, there are some available commands. For example, set session variables. You can show the model information. You can load the model, I mean the session, or you can save your current session. So, and you can clear the session context. For example, if I say clear, and now I ask again, what did I just ask? You didn't ask anything yet. Okay, you see, it forgot. So far, so good, quite easy. So let's finish this conversation, slash by, and you're done. So far you didn't even need to be a programmer or a developer. You know, anyone could use these capabilities and you can just chat with the model in your terminal. But for developers, we can also visit their GitHub repo. And they have a very brief documentation, but brief but effective documentation here. For example, you see for quick start, this is the command Ollama run Llama 3.2. These are some of the models with their number of parameters and their size. And it runs the models by default on your CPU, but if you have GPU and CUDA installed, you can also pass a flag and make it use your GPU. So it will be way faster. And you can also customize models. You know, Ollama supports Modelfile. You know, it has a Modelfile, you can define it. And the syntax is quite like Docker files, and you could guess from the naming, you know, Modelfile is just like Docker file. So we can also customize an LLM. For example, I've downloaded Llama 3.2, but I can make a customized LLM out of that. Of course, it doesn't copy the whole model. You know, the model is just there, and we have one copy of that. But you can run it with different configurations. Let me show you what I mean. For example, let me save this model file. And just like Docker, you see we have this from syntax from Llama 3.2. And we can set some parameters such as temperature. If you're familiar with how LLMs work under the hood, we can set the top K, the maximum P, the minimum P. We can set all of those parameters. So for example, I can say parameter temperature. And I can set it to 1 to be more creative. By default, I guess it's 0.7 or 0.8. So just as a quick introduction for those who are not familiar with temperature in language models, the lower the temperature, the more deterministic will the LLM behave, and you will have maybe more conservative or more, you know, I can say probably more correct answers, but at the same time, it doesn't explore much. So if you want your answers to be more explorative, more creative, you can increase the temperature. And then you can also specify a system message. We're familiar with system message from the previous videos. You know, the system message is a fixed piece of prompt that you always pass to the LLM. So I can say system, and I can say for example, you are a helpful pirate that talks in pirate slang. Yeah, okay, this is good enough. And then here's the command, Ollama create. You can name it. What is the name of this customized language model? And then you should pass it the file, the model file, and then you can start chatting with your model. So I can say Ollama create, I will call it MH Pirate, and I should pass the file, and here's the file, model file. Done. And now I can say Ollama run MH Pirate. Okay, now let's say, hi, how are you? I be doing ground matey. May they be filled with treasure and swashbuckling fun. Okay, it's fun. So anything you ask, it will answer like a pirate. So let me ask something funny. Can you develop a function in Python to print all prime numbers from 1 to 100. Our matey, I can help you with that. Here be a Python function that prints all prime numbers between 1 and 100. So yeah, it's doing its job. Okay, so you get the idea. How simple is that? And okay, it's starting another implementation. Let me stop it. And I can just say bye. You see how simple that works? And maybe you just want to download or pull a model without immediately chatting with it. You can use the pull command. Or if you want to remove a model, maybe it's taking a lot of space and you want to get rid of it. So Ollama RM, you know, the documentation is quite readable and simple. I'm sure you can read it yourself. I just want to give you a big picture and idea how it works. And, you know, I just want to introduce Ollama to you. And as another step, let me call it from Python. So, for example, we can call this mhpirate LLM from inside Python. I can create a test ollama.py, and you see here's a link to the Python library, Ollama Python, and you just need to install it using pip install ollama, and the usage is super simple. So just from ollama you should import the chat function, and then you can call it. You should specify the model. Maybe you have some prior messages or context, and then you're good to go. So let's say from Ollama import chat. And now I can say result equals chat. So we should specify model. I can say mhpirate because it's a model in Ollama now. And then I can specify prior messages. So, for example, this is how the message works. I should say, what is the role? It is from the user. And what is the content? The content is, how can I rob a bank? Let's see what it says. Okay. And then I can print the result. I guess a better idea is to pretty print it, but let's go with print for now. Python test Ollama. Okay. So I cannot provide information or guidance on illegal or harmful activities. Okay, it's fine. So I guess we're connected to the model because this answer is coming from that model, but let's try another fun prompt. Tell me a brief memory of your pirate times. A brief and funny memory. We should wait until it has all of our answer. Okay, here's the answer. Okay, so I guess you can read it better than me. So you get the idea. Here's how you can interact with the model from Python. And of course, in the next video, I'll show you how to build an agent that uses a local LLM using Ollama. And just for one last thing, all we did so far was to interact with Ollama from the terminal or from Python. But maybe we want to also have a pretty clean and beautiful UI that we can use, something like ChatGPT website, for example, that it keeps our previous chats and also We can continue our previous chats. We can set the model. We can, you know, create customized models just the way we did with Modelfile, for example. So there are a bunch of UIs and apps developed for this purpose. One of the most famous ones is Msty. We can visit their website, Msty.app. And again, the installation is super simple. I'm sure you can handle it. You can just download it and follow the instructions. And once you have Msty, if you run it for the first time, it will ask you if you have Ollama or not. And just by just clicking on that button, on a button that says, okay, yeah, I have Ollama, then it connects with Ollama models. So let me run Msty and show you how it works. It's super simple, but it's also very effective for daily usage, because honestly, we don't want to work with terminal every day for, you know, very simple tasks. So you can see here's a list of your conversations. You can specify which model you want to use, and you see it has Image Pirate as well. So I can choose to work with DeepSeek or Llama. I've downloaded them before. So for example, I can start with Gemma and say, how can I count the number of prime numbers from 1 to 100 in Python? Something like this. And the model answers. Okay, you see, it's starting to develop a function. And you can also see your local LLMs as well as other LLMs that are not downloaded or pulled yet, but you can download them very easily. You can see the size of each model. Maybe it's good for text tasks, maybe for vision, maybe for reasoning, and what is the size. And you can download them. Of course, you see, for example, if you have a medium size or even a small size, for it differs based on machines, but for my machine right now, and it's not connected to power, but it's a little bit slow. But if you have, you know, power and also you use a lightweight model, it will run really fast. And what else did I want to say? And it also has a remote model provider. You can pass your API keys from OpenAI or from Google, and you can also use your ChatGPT models here. And you can also pass knowledge stacks. So this is exactly a RAG application. If you're not familiar with RAG, don't worry about it. Very briefly speaking, maybe you have a lot of documents and you wanna also include them in your chat so that the model can look at those documents and give your answer based on those. So this is how you should do that, and the steps are very clear. You can follow the instructions, and it also has some prompt libraries. You see lots of prompts for different use cases. You can use those prompts as well. And I guess that's it. You know, I don't believe I should teach you all the details and what each button does. I'm sure you can handle that yourself. So in my opinion, the best thing I could do is to introduce the big pictures and concepts, and I'm sure you can then, if you're interested, you can then go and dive deep into these materials. So if you know any interesting use case of LLM models or projects that we can do with these kinds of tools like Ollama and LLM models, please drop them in the comments, and I will certainly record some videos with your name about those ideas as well. So in the next video, I'm going to talk about how to build an agent with a local LLM. So until the next video, take care.